KSBW Weather Plus with Jim VanderZwan.
All right, I have it on good account there. Packing up all the cowboys and moving them on out. Next thing on the list, of course, the Garlic Festival coming up, and it is feeling a lot like summer. Look at that. There's your stratus. That's typical for July. Yeah, love it or hate it, it's there. North end of the bay, sunny side up for most of the day. South end, never saw it. To marine layers hovering at about 1,500 feet. So we've got that a little ceiling. That allows for a difference in temperatures. Got some 80s in Boulder Creek, Ben Lomond, Scotts Valley 79, then 67 in Watsonville. And we ended up with 59 for a high in Pacific Grove and in Marina today. 61 in Seaside and about 10 degrees warmer in Carmel Valley. So a little cooler than it could be, and probably some of the coolest numbers in the whole country right now. And that's likely going to be around for a while. 67 in Salinas today. It was up to 79 in King City. The hot spot was Morgan Hill, 92. Now, see, they're just in the right place, right up against the foothills here. They don't get much of the sea breeze off the bay, and they don't get much as it punches out through San Juan Bautista and Hollister. So that tends to be the hottest place in the summer in the four-county area. Matching up with that, 92 right now in Sacramento, all triple digits in Redding and Fresno, and about half that warm in Eureka. Cool spot there. 82 at Lake Tahoe today, gorgeous up in the High Sierra. 109 in Vegas, you can get 110 degrees going on you right now in Palm Springs. That is hot. 81 in Van Nuys, but 60s along the coast there in the Southland as well. Nice and warm through the Southwest. Once you get on the other side of New Mexico, it gets pretty muggy. Lots of 90s even at this hour. 82 in New York, 76 in Bismarck, 66 in Seattle, where never got above 67. Almost hit 90 Boise and 110 in Phoenix. 90 in St. Louis, 94 in New York City, and there was plenty of heat all the way up into New England, all the way down to Florida, and of course, a lot of that's pretty sticky stuff. Thunder and lightning, had a batch of that going around too. A couple of systems, really. One on the East Coast right now brings some rain and some showers and thunderstorms, also in the upper Mississippi River Valley and off the Front Range of the Rockies. Hail and high winds so far. No tornadoes reported. Get a little bit of monsoon action here in the four corner states. Also typical. So at least we're kind of on schedule for this second part of July here. High pressure drawing up the moisture off the Sierra Madre, and then we'll see the rest of it moving along these ripples that go over Canada, and that'll get you some thunderstorms over parts of the Mississippi River Valley all the way into the Ohio Valley, and some of that gets occasionally nasty, but nothing too terrible. Meanwhile, low clouds along the California coast, normal. We'll keep an eye on what comes out of here. That likely won't be an issue till late in the week, maybe Saturday. We'll see some thunderstorms over the Sierra Nevada and the like, but for now, as you go on with that northwest flow, marine layer will increase in altitude, so we'll see more cooling moving into the coast. By tomorrow, we don't see a whole lot of those red, bright colors on the microcast, which means it's going to be moderate for this time of year. So no big heat wave this time around. Pretty comfortable numbers, really, if you got to work. 60s and 70s in the Bay Area ought to do it, and we'll figure on mid-70s to about mid-80s for the Santa Clara Valley with lows in the 50s. So the prospects are looking pretty comfortable here. 60s and 70s for most of the Salinas Valley. Like, you're going to have to get south of Greenfield to get into the 80s. And once you get way south here, still doing some 90s. So you just got to get far enough away from the beaches to get hot. But 60s will do it along the coast, and overnight lows for just about everybody. 50s still look pretty good. Some mid to upper 70s up the Santa Cruz Mountains and mid-60s between Davenport and Moss Landing ought to serve you pretty well as well. Clear, some coastal low clouds moving locally into the Salinas Valley, parts of the south end of Santa Clara Valley. The Bay low clouds will clear by mid-May, except around about the peninsula. I think we'll keep it there. And then as that marine layer lifts, we get more low clouds, a little bit of local drizzle along the coast, lingering around the bay, particularly the south end of the bay. Inland, still plenty of sunshine. So we'll keep with 70s and 80s for most of the week. Now, by the weekend, we'll add a few more 90s into the mix there, so things begin to warm up just a little bit, but nothing super hot. And, of course, lots of 60s for highs along the coast. And by Thursday and Friday, we may see it shift from northwest to southwest, which means more of that low clouds might move up around the north end of the Monterey Bay for a couple of days. But I think just some high clouds Saturday will do it for now. We'll keep an eye on that. See if we get some subtropical moisture. So we're right in the pocket where we ought to be, Dan. Still not a bad place to be, considering how hot it is elsewhere.
We're in.
We're in. Yeah, we're doing all right. So we'll set it up for the Garlic Festival. We'll keep you posted on that.